Grace and greetings to you in the name of the Lord. Good to be with you today. Very eager to jump into our continuing dialogue on the book of James. We are in chapter 1, verse 17. But I also want you to note we're going to jump ahead 10 verses, sort of, to verse 27. When we talk about pure and undefiled religion is this, taking care of orphans and widows. And one of our great opportunities to do so has presented itself. I've included it in this post in the commentary that we are helping out. We Are the Echo, a phenomenal ministry that serves orphanages in the Hampton Roads area. They have a lot of need right now for various materials that's listed in the dialogue there. If you can contribute any of these items, I have given different ways that you may do so. Please take a read on that. If you can contribute and you need to set up a drop-off, I'm happy to coordinate with you on that. If you want to give financially, there is a way by which you can do that as well. But take a read on that, see what you can do. And in the meantime, let's jump into our discussion. We try to keep this as a wonderful daily devotion style, not necessarily a sermon, so I want to be mindful of your time. We talked yesterday about every good gift being from the Father. And had some great discussion on his goodness and the goodness of his gifts. Notably, Vicky Ash came with a phenomenal list that you should check out of all of the good things that God provides in Scripture. Great context on that, and I commend you on that, Vicky. Great research, great endeavor to study to show yourself approved, no doubt. But we closed out yesterday with that wonderful phrase that James provides us, that God is the Father of lights, in whom there is no variation nor shadow of turning. And I want to just share a little bit on that today that I am confident will bless you. When we talk about the Father of lights, indeed, our Father is the creator of the heaven and the earth. So he is the creator of the physical. He opens up by saying, let there be light. But that's also a spiritual connotation. Christ is the light of the world. Ultimately, we are seated in heavenly places, according to Ephesians. And so you see a dichotomy in the creation account. At one point, the Genesis account talks about the greater light to rule the day, the lesser light to rule the night. The greater light to rule the day is, of course, the sun. The lesser light to rule the night is the moon. In many ways, we are like the moon. If you'll look at the moon, though it can illuminate the darkness of night, the fact is the moon is not an illuminating body. It does not produce light. It only reflects light, the light of the sun. And that's what we are called to be. Reflections of the light and the love of Christ. The S-O-N. So when we look at the Father of lights, he is the Father of all created light, but especially all spiritual light. Even in that context, the spiritual lights that we are, seated in heavenly places, are much like the physical lights that have been created. They are all subject to variation. They're not always in the same place. The heavenly bodies move. Their light does not always shine with consistent intensity. When you look at the moon, it can be a quarter moon, a half moon, a three-quarter moon, a full moon. It can be absent. And there are some times in our lives where we just do not reflect the light of God very well. So these lesser lights are not steady or persistent or consistent in the giving of light, but God is. In him, there is no variation, no shadow of turning. So when we look at that passage, no variation. His light is perfect. It is persistent. It is consistent. And there is no shadow of turning, James says. Now, we might not understand what he's saying in that context, but his hearers certainly would. His hearers understand that the variation in the shadow of turning is referring to the way they managed time and could tell time. And that is when you look at At the time, Beast, I'm very sorry for coughing. The rain didn't clear out all of the pollen. But what you would have is basically a triangular shape that was set atop a pillar. And you could tell the time of the day by the shadow that was cast as the sun moved across the sky. Now, when the sun is at its apex, its highest point, there is no shadow cast by that mechanism. That would tell the individual it's noontime. The sun is at its apex. By James saying there is no variation, no shadow of turning in God, that tells us that God is always at his apex. There are not times when he's stronger, better, more giving, more loving than at others. He is always at his apex, at his top spot. Now, we are not. We are, much like those heavenly bodies, there is variation. There is times that we're brighter than others, and times that we do better than other times, no doubt about it. But in God, there is not. He is always at the peak of his game. So as we consider God in this way, I would encourage you to pray on that and to recognize that there are not times that God is having a bad day. There's not times that God is not giving the fullness of his light in our lives. The question is, why does it not reflect in us as well? What has caused? Have we turned? Is there something between us and God? Think about an eclipse for a moment and how the light will be prevented from reaching us if there is another body that stands between us and the light. What might that be in your life? I'm interested to hear what you come up with this. I'm interested to hear your insights, your prayer, what God reveals to you, what God shares with you. Feel free to share this post. Feel free to comment on this post. Feel free to create your own post and say, hey, here's what God shared with me. And even as we talk, you're always welcome to type something in and say, well, hey, does this mean that? Or, hey, I read once, or, hey, God revealed to me this. And we can make this into a discussion point as well. In the meantime, realize that every good gift is from the Father above, and his goodness is always at its peak, and he is always pouring out the perfect blessing. Let us find whatever is casting the shadow and get it out of the way. And if we are not at our full peak, let's turn toward God so that we can reflect that light perfectly. I look forward to hearing the great blessings from this. Please take a read on the material I'm posting at the top of this so that we can help out the orphans and those in foster care in the area. Thank you so much for your willingness to pray for them and to provide for them. And if there's anything we can do for you, let us know. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Talk to you again soon. Blessings.